Hello students, good afternoon. So we are discussing about algebra of complex numbers. So we have discussed addition and difference of complex numbers. Okay. So in this session, we will go through multiplication of complex numbers. Multiplication of complex numbers. So when two complex numbers are given, or more than two complex numbers are given, how do we multiply them? Okay. So let's take two complex numbers theoretically. Let z1 is first complex number in the form a plus ib, and z2 is another complex number in the form c plus id. Then the product of these two complex numbers, or multiplication of these two complex numbers, represented by z1 into z2. So it is a plus ib into c plus id. Now how do we multiply these two? If you observe, in case of addition or subtraction, what is z1 plus z2 we have written? Addition of complex numbers, we are adding the corresponding real parts and we are adding the corresponding imaginary parts. So it is a plus c plus I into b plus d. In case of difference also, we are subtracting the corresponding real parts and subtract corresponding imaginary parts. Whereas in case of multiplication of complex numbers, we cannot just multiply the corresponding real parts and corresponding imaginary parts. Okay, it is not like that in case of multiplication. So in case of multiplication, what we do is, we take each term and multiply with the remaining all the terms. Okay, so take a, multiply to these two terms, then take ib, multiply to these two terms. Okay, so element wise we are multiplying a into c, it is ac, a into id, so iad, ib into c, ibc, next plus ib into id, it is I square bd, ib into id, it is I square bd. Simplify, ac plus I, we can take common from these two, ad plus bc, next plus I square bd. What is I square value? We know minus 1 into bd. So it is ac plus I into ad plus bc minus bd. AC is real, minus bd is real. So real part I write AC minus bd plus I into AD plus BC. So this is the product of complex numbers z1 into z2. Understand? So you don't have to remember the formula as such. Okay, just take two complex numbers, multiply element wise and simplify, will get the required product. Okay, so now you need to remember the formula. See, for example, let z1 is 3 minus 4i and z2 is minus 1 plus 2i. Then what is z1 into z2? Okay, the product we take 3 minus 4i into minus 1 plus 2i. So multiply element wise, 3 into minus 1 minus 3, next 3 into plus 2i plus 6i, minus 4i into minus 1 plus 4i, minus 4i into 2i, minus into plus is minus, 4i into 2i, 8i square. Understand? So minus 3 plus 6i plus 4i, 10i, minus 8 into I square is minus 1. So minus 3 plus 10i, minus into minus is plus 8, minus 3 plus 8, it is plus 5 plus 10i. So this is the product z1 into z2. Understand? So just take the two terms, two complex numbers given, multiply element wise and simplify. Okay, we'll get the required product. See another example. Our question will be asked like this. Write the complex number. Write the complex number four plus three I into two minus I in the form A plus IB. So writing the complex number 4 plus 3i into 2 minus I in the form A plus IB means this is the product of complex numbers. See, if you multiply the two complex numbers, we will get another complex number. Now that we have to write in the form A plus IB. Understand? Let us take a given complex number in the form Z 4 plus 3i into 2 minus I. So multiply 4 into 2, 8, 4 into minus I, minus 4i, 3i into 2, 6i, plus into minus, minus 3i into I, 3i square. So 8 minus 4i plus 6i plus 2i minus 3 into I square is minus 1. So 8 plus 2i plus 3, real part 11 plus 2i. So the simplified form of given complex number is 11 plus 2i. It is in the form A plus IB. Okay, so it is of the form A plus IB, where A is 11, B is 2. B is not 2i. Okay, sometimes many students will be writing B as 2i. B is not 2i. A plus IB form, I is already written, so B is 2 only, not 2i. Understand? Next, write one note. Important. Many times when we are solving the problems, we will come across this formula. X plus IY into X minus IY is X square plus Y square. Okay. X plus IY into X minus IY, it is X square plus Y square. So you can remember it as formula, because many times we will be using this product. A plus IB into A minus IB form, or X plus IY into X minus IY form. So formula is X square plus Y square here. Okay. Now observe the difference. In terms of real numbers, we studied same type of formula, X plus Y into X minus Y. So in real numbers, X and Y are real. What is X plus Y into X minus Y we are writing? It is X square minus Y square. But here, X plus IY into X minus IY, we are taking the product of complex numbers. So here the product is X square plus Y square. It is not a minus Y square. Okay. So see the proof of this. So take left hand side, X plus IY into X minus IY. So two terms are given, we can multiply them. Multiply X into X, X square, X into minus IY, minus IXY, IY into X plus IXY, plus into minus, minus IY into IY, I square Y square. Okay, element wise we are multiplying. Simplify, X square minus IXY plus IXY, it will get cancelled, minus I square y square. What is I square value? Minus 1 into y square. So x square minus into minus is plus y square, which is equal to RHS. Okay. So formula is important. X plus iy into x minus iy is x square plus y square. Or in terms of AB, if I write, A plus IB into A minus IB is A square plus B square. Understand? So this also comes under multiplication of complex numbers. Next, let us see some properties based on this multiplication of complex numbers. Properties of multiplication of complex numbers. So first one is closure law. So when we multiply two complex numbers, we are getting another complex number, as we have seen in that examples. Okay, product of two complex numbers is another complex number. So that is what closure law. Z1 into Z2 is another complex number in the form Z. Okay, next, second one, commutative law. Multiplication of complex numbers obeys commutative law. So that is, for two complex numbers Z1, Z2, the product Z1 into Z2 same as Z2 into Z1. Okay. Next, associative law is obeyed. That is, for three complex numbers Z1, Z2, Z3, Z1 into Z2 into Z3. Will be same as Z1 into Z2 into Z3. Okay, so this also obeyed. We can take some example and verify. Okay, so take Z1, Z2, Z3 as three different complex numbers. Find left hand side, find right hand side. We'll get both are equal. Okay, so associative law is obeyed by the multiplication of complex numbers. Next, distributive law. So multiplication over addition, multiplication over subtraction, so that is obeyed in case of multiplication of complex numbers. So distributive law is obeyed. That is, Z1 into Z2 plus Z3 can be written as Z1 into Z2 plus Z1 into Z3. The same in terms of difference, Z1 into Z2 minus Z3, it is Z1, Z2 minus Z1 into Z3. Okay, so this is a multiplication over addition and subtraction. So distributive law will be obeyed. Next, existence of multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity. So for a given complex number Z, what will be the multiplicative identity? So in terms of real numbers, we know what is the multiplicative identity. Suppose A is a real number. If A is a real number, what is the multiplicative identity? A into 1 same as 1 into A same as given number A. Okay. In real numbers, when A is a real number, if I multiply 1 to any real number, multiplication of 1 to any real number, so what is the product we get? The same number A. So here 1 is called as the multiplicative identity in real numbers. Similarly, in terms of complex numbers, for the given complex number, if I multiply 1, what is the product we get? Same complex number Z only. So z into 1 same as 1 into z same as z. So 1 is called as the multiplicative identity. Okay, so 1, now 1 I can write as 1 plus I into 0, because we are calling it as a complex number, so it will have real as well as the imaginary part. So 1 I can write as 1 plus I into 0 is the multiplicative identity. 1 is called as the multiplicative identity. Understand? Next, we will define multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse. So what is mean by multiplicative inverse in real numbers? In case of real numbers, suppose A is a real number. If you multiply another real number, the product should be 1. So what should be the number we multiply? It is 1 by A. So for the given real number A, which is not equal to 0, A into 1 by A is equal to 1 by A into A is always equal to 1. So 1 by A is called as the multiplicative inverse of A. Okay, so multiplicative inverse of A is 1 by A. It is denoted by A inverse. This is what we know in terms of real numbers. So same we can apply in terms of complex numbers also. For the given complex number Z, if I multiply one more complex number 1 by Z, the product will be always 1. So z into 1 by z, which is 1 by z into z, the product is always 1. So 1 by z is called as the multiplicative inverse of given complex number z. Okay, so here 1 by z, which is denoted by z power minus 1 or z inverse. So 1 by z equal to z inverse is called the multiplicative inverse of complex number z. Okay, so if you are asked to find what is the multiplicative inverse of complex number z, so what you have to find is, we have to find a 1 by z, that is nothing but a z inverse. Okay, so we can write z into 1 by z, means I can write z inverse is equal to z inverse into z is always equal to 1. So z inverse is called as the multiplicative inverse of z. Understand? Next, again note, suppose z is a complex number, let z is equal to a plus ib be a complex number, then its inverse, okay, multiplicative inverse of given complex number z is equal to a plus ib, it is a minus ib divided by a square plus b square. Okay, it is a minus ib divided by a square plus b square. Okay, let us see the proof. So z is given, we need z inverse. Given z is a plus ib, so here what is z inverse I can write? Z inverse is nothing but 1 by z. Understand? Z inverse is nothing but 1 by z. So it is 1 by z is a plus ib. So 1 by a plus ib, we have to simplify this. Now for simplification of this, if you observe I is present in the denominator. Okay, usually we write I in the numerator, so that any complex number we write in the form real plus imaginary part. Okay, that is a plus IB form or x plus IY form. So here I is there in denominator. So to simplify this, what we do is we rationalize the denominator. Okay. So multiply and divide here. This is what we have. So multiplying and dividing a minus IB. Okay. Multiply and divide a minus IB and simplify. See what we get. So Z inverse is equal to numerator 1 into a minus ib is a minus ib divided by denominator a plus ib into a minus ib. So what is the denominator multiplication? A plus ib into a minus ib. It is in the form x plus iy into x minus iy. What is the formula? X square plus y square. So in place of x and y we have ab. So the product is here a square plus b square. Okay. Now if you want separate real and imaginary parts, divide separately. A by a square plus b square minus ib divided by a square plus b square. So this is a multiplicative inverse of given complex number Z. Understand? So again, you don't have to remember this formula. If you can remember, that is well and good. Okay, but not compulsory, because any complex number given, if I want to find its inverse, we just have to take its reciprocal 1 by Z and then simplify. Then we will get the multiplicative inverse of given complex number. Understand? So these are the properties based on multiplication of complex numbers. We'll take one example how to find the multiplicative inverse of given complex number. Okay. See the example. Find multiplicative inverse of complex number two minus three I. Find the multiplicative inverse of complex number two minus three I. So one thing you can do is compare it to the form a plus IB. A is 2, B is minus 3. Apply the formula. In one step, we will get the answer. If you can remember formula. If you don't remember formula, then we take, let us take given complex number is Z, 2 minus 3i. So for any complex number Z, what is the multiplicative inverse? Multiplicative inverse of Z is Z inverse is equal to 1 by Z. So Z inverse is 1 by Z. What is Z here? 2 minus 3. Now what we do is we just simplify this. To simplify we have to rationalize. So 1 by 2 minus 3 I. So how to rationalize? Minus is there. So multiply and divide 2 plus 3 I. Multiply and divide 2 plus 3i. Simplify it. 1 into 2 plus 3i is 2 plus 3i divided by 2 minus 3i into 2 plus 3i. It is in the form a minus ib into a plus ib. When it is in that form, directly we write the formula a square plus b square. If it is not in that form, we have to multiply each term and simplify. So since it is in the form a minus ib into a plus ib, I can write a square plus b square. B is 3. B is not 3i. B is only 3. If we take 3i and square, we will get wrong answer. Okay, A is 2, B is 3. So simplifying, 2 plus 3i divided by 4 plus 9 is 13. So dividing separately, 2 by 13 plus 3 by 13 into i. So this is the multiplicative inverse of given complex number Z inverse. Understand? Let's see another example. Find multiplicative inverse of Z is equal to minus I. Okay, so simply they given multiplicative inverse of the complex number Z is equal to minus I. So any complex number, maybe it is I or minus I, or any some real number given, any number given or any complex number given, multiplicative inverse is 1 by Z. So multiplicative inverse of Z is Z inverse is equal to 1 by Z. So Z inverse is 1 by Z is minus I. I can write minus 1 by I. Okay, 1 by minus I is nothing but minus 1 by I. Now again we have I in the denominator. Okay, so I is in the denominator means we can multiply and divide I, or we can multiply divide minus I. Anything will get answer same. Minus I by I we have. So to simplify it, I will multiply and divide I here. Okay, even if I multiply and divide minus I, minus minus will get cancelled. Okay, usually take the opposite sign of denominator. We have 2 minus 3i, so we multiply divide 2 plus 3i. But here there is no real part, only we have imaginary part. So for that imaginary part, whether you take plus I or minus I and multiply divide, that minus will get cancelled. So still we get I only. Numerator minus 1 into I, minus I. Divide by I into I is I square. So minus I by I square value minus 1. So minus minus cancel, it is I. So the multiplicative inverse of given complex number Z equal to minus I is Z inverse, which is equal to I. Understand how to find multiplicative inverse of any complex number given? Okay. Next, division of complex numbers. Division of complex numbers. So when two complex numbers are given, let Z1 is in the form A plus IB and Z2 is in the form C plus ID be two complex numbers. So that Z2 is not equal to 0, means C not equal to 0 and D not equal to 0. Then the division of these two, Z1 by Z2, it is written as A plus IB divided by C plus ID. Okay, A plus IB divided by C plus ID. Now this we have to simplify. Understand? See, Z1 by Z2, by simplifying that, again we are getting some complex number. Now complex number always write in the form X plus IY or A plus IB. Now I is present in both numerator and denominator. Usually we write I in the numerator. Okay, so C plus ID in denominator. So what I do is I will rationalize this. If we rationalize it, then we'll get I in the numerator only. So A plus IB divided by C plus ID. Rationalize C minus ID divided by C minus ID. Now numerator is nothing but multiplication of the two complex numbers. A plus IB into C minus ID. Denominator C plus ID into C minus ID. Numerator multiply each term. A into C, AC. A into minus ID, minus IAD. IB into C plus IBC. Plus into minus, minus IB into ID, I square BD. Divided by, observe denominator C plus ID into C minus ID. It is in the form A plus IB into A minus IB, which we can write C square plus D square. Numerator AC plus I will take common from these two. It is BC minus AD. Next, I square is minus 1, minus into minus plus BD divided by C square plus D square. So what will be the division of these two? Z1 by Z2 we can write. It is, this is real part, this is real part. AC plus BD. Divided by C square plus D square plus I into BC minus AD divided by C square plus D square. Okay. So the division of two complex numbers is also a complex number in the form X plus I1. Understand? So this is how we can divide any two complex numbers. So again, you don't have to remember the formula as such. Just take the division of the two complex numbers. Maybe sometimes they will ask Z1 by Z2 or sometimes they will ask Z2 by Z1. So in any case, just divide the complex numbers, rationalize the denominator, simplify, we will get the complex number in the form X plus IY. Understand? See, for example, write the complex number minus 1 plus I divided by 2 minus 3I in the form A plus IB. Write the complex number minus 1 plus I divided by 2 minus 3I in the form A plus IB. Means you have to simplify this and write in this A plus IB form. If you observe, it is nothing but the division of two complex numbers. So let us take given complex number as Z, minus 1 plus I divided by 2 minus 3I. Now we have to simplify it. Rationalize denominator. So multiply and divide 2 plus 3I. Multiply and divide 2 plus 3i. See what we get. Minus 1 into 2, minus 2. Minus 1 into 3i, minus 3i. I into 2 plus 2i. Plus into plus, plus 3i square. Next, denominator 2 minus 3i into 2 plus 3i. It is in the form a minus ib into a plus ib, a square plus b square. So minus 2 minus I 3I square, it is minus 3. I square is minus 1 into 3 divided by 13. So it is minus 5 minus I divided by 13. So given complex number is in the form A plus IB, okay, which is of the form A plus IB, where what is A value? Minus 5 by 13. B value? Minus 1 by 13. Understand? So division of complex numbers, take the division as it is, rationalize denominator, simplify, we'll get in the form a plus ib. Okay. Next, we study about modulus of complex number. Modulus of a complex number. Okay, so any complex number is given in the form z is equal to a plus ib. Let z is equal to a plus ib be any complex number, then its modulus is denoted by mod z. Modulus of the complex number, it is denoted by mod z, and it is defined as square root of the real part square. What is the real part here? A plus imaginary part square. What is the imaginary part? Is it b or ib? Imaginary part is b. Okay, so real part square plus imaginary part square, square root of real part square plus imaginary part square. So this value is called as the modulus of complex number denoted by mod z. Understand? This is the definition of modulus of complex number. See, for example, let z1 is 2 plus 3i, then what is mod z here, or mod z1? It is root of real part square, real part is 2, so 2 square plus imaginary part square, imaginary part is 3 square. Simplify the value, we will get root 13. So modulus of z1 value is root 13. Okay, next, see another example. Let z2 is complex number in the form minus 4 plus 3i. Z2 is in the form minus 4 plus 3i. Then what is the modulus of z2 here? It is square root of real part square. What is the real part? Minus 4 plus imaginary part square, 3 square. So root of 16 plus 9, root 25 is 5. Okay, this is the modulus of z. Next, suppose we have complex number z3 is minus 3i. So z3 equal to minus 3i, or let's take minus 2i. Now minus 2i, it is a complex number. Which type? It is purely imaginary, there is no real part. Now for this also we can write mod z. So it is modulus of z3, it is square root of any complex number given, just take a real part square plus imaginary part square on the root. So root of real part is 0, 0 square, imaginary part is minus 2 whole square. So 0 plus minus 2 whole square is 4, now root 4 is 2. So modulus of this complex number is 2. Understand? This is the definition of modulus. Now there are some properties based on this modulus. Properties of modulus of complex number. First property is modulus of the product. Modulus of z1 into z2 can be written as mod z1 into mod z2, because sometimes simplification of this product will be lengthy and then taking modulus will be complex. So in such case, modulus of z1 into z2 is nothing but mod z1 into mod z2. Now for each complex number we can find modulus easily and then take the product. Okay, next, modulus of z1 by z2, if it is a division, modulus of z1 by z2, it is mod z1 divided by mod z2. Again, first finding the division of complex numbers, again taking modulus, it will be lengthy. So this is same as mod z1 by mod z2. You find this number and then divide. Okay, next, third property, modulus of z power n, like modulus of z square or mod z power, modulus of z power 5. So finding z power 5 and taking modulus will be complex. So in such case, it is written as mod z whole power n. So modulus of z power n is nothing but mod z whole power n. Understand? So these are the properties based on the modulus of complex number. Okay, next, one more topic, conjugate of complex number. Conjugate of a complex number. Suppose ZB a complex number in the form A plus IB, then its conjugate denoted by Z bar, the conjugate of complex number, it is denoted by Z bar, and Z bar is defined as A minus IB. Okay, A minus IB is called as the conjugate of complex number. See here difference, in the given complex number, imaginary part is positive, so here imaginary part will become negative. Okay, real part is same. For the conjugate complex number, imaginary part only changes, real part remains same. So real part is same, we are just changing the sign of the imaginary part. So this is called as the conjugate of complex number. Okay, see, for example, let z1 is 3 plus 4i, then what will be z1 bar? We can write real part is same, only we are changing the sign of imaginary part, so it will become 3 minus 4a. Next, suppose z2 is a complex number in the form minus 2 minus 2 minus 3i, then what will be conjugate? Real part being same, so real part is minus 2 only, we have to change the sign of imaginary part. Imaginary part is minus 3i, so changing its sign, it will become plus 3. Okay, so conjugate we are writing like this, z2 is complex number, z2 bar is the conjugate. Next, suppose complex number is like this, z3 is equal to 10, here we have only the real part, there is no imaginary part. Okay, so then what will be z3 bar here? What will be z3 bar? Real part being same, 10 only, since there is no imaginary part, so no need to change the sign. Okay, so z3 bar also 10 only. Next, suppose we have z4 is minus 5i, then what will be the conjugate? Real part is 0 here, so there is no real part, imaginary part is minus 5i. So changing the sign of the imaginary part, will get plus 5i. This is a conjugate. Okay, so any complex number given, we keep the real part same, just change the sign of the imaginary part, then we'll get this conjugate. Okay, now properties on conjugate. First property, Z1 plus or minus Z2 conjugate. Z1 plus or minus Z2 conjugate means Z1 plus Z2 whole bar or Z1 minus Z2 whole bar. It is Z1 bar plus or minus Z2 bar. Okay. So take the conjugate separately and add or subtract. That is the first property. Next, Z1 into Z2 whole bar means first we are finding the product Z1 into Z2, then we are taking its conjugate. So it may be lengthy to simplify. It will be same as Z1 bar into Z2 bar. Next, Z1 by Z2 whole bar. It is Z1 bar divided by Z2. Okay. So these are some properties based on the conjugate of complex number. Okay. So combining modulus and conjugate, there are some more properties we can study. So that we'll see in the next class. Okay. Thank you.